now that we've applied the dome tape to the domes and we're ready to go install our new domes into our existing framed skylight, there are a couple things we want to go over. So when you get up on the roof to pull the metal retainer frame off and go to install your new set, a common question is, do we apply silicone here? If you look on our complete skylight, nowhere, anywhere in the frame is there silicone. And most skylights have a very simple design underneath where the dome sits. So on our skylight, the domes sit on top of a little trough. On our skylight, there's a little vinyl gasket that goes in that trough. Fortunately, it's specially formulated for our skylight, so we typically don't sell this piece of vinyl. It's designed just for our skylight. The dome sits on top of that. On a lot of older skylights, the plastic sits just flush on metal. It won't harm anything. It's just giving the plastic a little bit of a buffer. But yeah, and again, there's a look at your condensation gutter on the inside. It's designed to trap the water, force it to the corner, and we just punch the corner of our skylight. Every skylight's going to have a slightly different design, but they'll all have the same mechanism, some way to collect the water and force it out of the unit. Okay, so the condensation gutter's on the inside here, and then this outside channel is designed to trap any water that would seep in through where the outside of the metal retainer frame is pushing down on the plastic. It's going to collect it in that channel and also force it to the corner where it'll exit out of the unit. So one of the most common issues we see with homeowners and installers is they think they have to make their skylight airtight, and they inadvertently come in and they block up all of these mechanisms that are designed to allow the water to weep out of the unit and prevent it from actually functioning properly. So the other issue with silicone, and the reason we don't typically recommend it on a residential skylight, is plastic's highly sensitive to chemicals. So if you're going to use a silicone, you really have to make sure that it's designed for use with either acrylic, polycarbonate, or Lexan plastic. If you need some recommendations, we can give you some, but for the most part, it's not needed. So now that you're up on the roof, you take your old broken domes off. You take the new domes that you already put together, and you place them right back in the frame. And you want to line that up. When we reassemble the skylight, we're going to grab the retainer frame, that outside metal frame of the skylight. We're going to push it down firmly on the base of the skylight, which is sandwiching the plastic in place, and then use the original screws to go back into the original holes to reassemble the skylight back together.